Hi, in this video we're going to talk about DuroMax generators. Now, DuroMax makes all kinds of great generators. The one I have here with me today is especially awesome. For one, it is dual fuel, which means you can use gasoline or propane to run your generator. And there are advantages, some serious ones to propane, and we'll talk about that. Also, this one has a handle, so you can actually pick it up. And it has another handle, and it comes with wheels already attached, so you can move it back and forth. Talk about portability. Now, DuroMax does make some generators that are a little bit less portable, and there are some advantages to going less portable. In this video, we're going to talk a little bit about...
We have an awesome generator from DuroMax, and DuroMax makes all kinds of generators. This one, I feel like, has all of the features. Like, this is one of the nicer ones, in my opinion. The big downside, though, is, of course, the price. You know, you can get a bigger, bulkier, stronger generator than this for less money, but you're not going to get all of the wonderful features. So let's talk a little bit about the features of this generator. So first of all, this one is what's called a dual fuel generator. So you can use gasoline or propane. And here you have the numbers. So you have 2,300 peak watts and 1,800 running watts with gasoline, or 2,150 peak watts and 1,700 running watts with propane. This is a good number. With a generator like this, you should be able to keep your food cold during emergencies. And the nice thing about propane is this. In certain states where it's a little bit more humid, if you use gasoline that contains like a lot of ethanol, that can cause problems over time if you let your generator sit. So having the option to use propane is a little bit cleaner, I think, in the long run for generators in certain areas. So it's nice to have the option. Also, you know, maybe during times of emergencies you can't find gas because the gas stations are sold out, and maybe you can find propane. Or conversely, maybe you can't find propane but you can find gas. So having two ways to power your generator is super, super useful. Here are some of the controls. Really nice design. I love the color of this generator. I love the blue. Just really nice. DuroMax. Yeah, really nice. Here's the pull cord. Here's some warning information.
Let me show you how to operate this handle. So not all of the DuroMax generators come with this. Again, this one's like loaded. This has all the nice features that you would want. And so basically, you can't pull it out. You have to push this button, and then you pull it out, and then you pull it out again, and then it's locked. And then you can pick it up. Oh, look at that. It's so lightweight. Yeah, the power of leverage. Ridiculous. Look at this. Wow, I'm not even that strong, and I can do it. Really amazing. Then to put it back in, you push it, and you push it. Now it's locked and you're good to go. Also, you have the option to pick it up, which is also quite easy. So it's a little bit heavy, but it's not too bad. You know, you can certainly get bigger, bulkier generators that are stronger than this one. But again, you lose the portability. You know, you're paying for the portability with a generator like this, right? You're paying for the dual fuel option. You're paying for the portability. And honestly, if you can afford it, I definitely think of it. This is so exciting. Here are some of the controls. So here you have some of the switches and stuff. And then here, look at this. USB, and I believe that's like a type C for like your iPhone, I believe. I'm not positive, but I'm pretty sure it is. Here you have some parallel connections. And then here you have, this is gold right here, boom, an AC outlet. And then over here, look, two more, right? So that's really nice. That's really nice. You've got a 30 amp and some 20 amps here. So beautiful, really nice. This is what it's all about, right? This is why people buy generators. You know, when you don't have electricity, you look around your house and you see all these outlets, and you can't use them because there's no power in there, and it just feels terrible. But if you have one of these, you know, you can plug your stuff into this. And the power on this one is perfect, by the way. Let's talk a little bit more about it. So with a generator like this, you should, again, I want to emphasize, should be able to keep your food cold during emergencies. Most of the time you can. These numbers here are rough, but you should be able to keep your food cold, and you should be able to run your lights and other things in your home during emergencies. So this is a good starting point. You can get weaker ones. I always recommend people try to get at least 2,000 to 2,400 watts. It's just a good compromise number. You can go higher, and you can probably get a stronger generator for less money, even a DuroMax, but you might not have all of the, you know, bells and whistles that this one has. This one, I feel, is completely loaded, right? You've got the dual fuel, you've got both handles. Oh, you've got the wheels. You know, a lot of times these generators, when you buy them, you have to put the wheels on. For example, I was recently looking at, I think it was a Champion generator. Oh, and the DeWalt, both. And both of the Champion and the DeWalt came with wheels, but you have to attach them, right? So This one doesn't have that. Also, the Champion generator in the DeWalt that I recently looked at, you could drag them with wheels, but you couldn't pick it up like this. Oh, no, no, no. I think they were twice as heavy as this one, right? And the reason is, this one is just a lot more portable.
I really love this generator. I think out of all the generators I've looked at recently, this is one of the nicer ones. I just love that it's dual fuel. Here's the propane stuff, comes with it. Got some more stuff here in a bag, a little tool kit. Let's open the bag and see what's inside. So here we have the typical tools that come with generators. You got a nice plug here, a wrench, and some other things that you can use. So even a little funnel. So it's nice that they throw in stuff like this because, you know, you pay a lot of money for one of these. And really what you're buying is this. I always like when they throw in the little perk. So when I opened the box, it came with this. It says, inside this envelope, quick start guide, registration card, manual, product brochure, cool stickers. Oh, that's so cool. So you open it up. And so you get everything you need here. And let me just recommend this because I think it's important. Always read the manual when you get your generator. Getting a generator should be a moment of joy, not frustration, right? You open your new generator, you can sit down, have a cup of tea, and read over the instructions and learn about your generator, right? Learn how to use it, learn how to maintain it, and learn how to use it safely, right? Generators are not toys. I mean, look at this. Stop. Notice, for safety, once fuel has been added to unit, you may not return to place of purchase. Okay. Your generator has been shipped without engine oil. Do not add fuel or start engine before adding oil. Yeah, so read all the warnings, right? Really, really.
Here you can see the backside of the generator. So really nice. I love the color, you know? It's just a nice change from some of the other colors. And here's the warning. And you know, I see this warning on every single generator. I wonder if it's maybe something that has to be put on there by law. I'm not really sure, but I was looking at another generator earlier and it has, they usually have this warning. Let's read it. Using a generator indoors can kill you in minutes. Right, so do not use indoors. Generator exhaust contains carbon monoxide. This is a poison you cannot see or smell. Never use inside a home or garage, even if doors and windows are open. Only use outside and far away from windows, doors, and vents. Avoid other generator hazards. Read manual before use. Yeah, read the instructions, and you should be good to go. Yeah, really nice. There's the run and the start and the choke. Beautiful. And there's the pull start. What a nice generator. So I think the biggest decision you have to make is which generator to buy. So first of all, should you even buy a DuroMax? Well, I think DuroMax is a pretty good brand. So yes, I think it's a good choice. But the bigger challenge will be to decide, you know, which model to get, right? Should you get one that's stronger than this or one that is weaker than this? My advice would be to get the best one you can afford. The last thing you want to do is buy a generator now. And no matter which one you buy, they all cost a significant amount of money, right? So you're going to be spending some money to buy one of these. Then look back 6 months and say, oh, you know, I watched that video on Amazon and I should have bought a better generator, right? Don't do that. Don't be that person. Don't have regrets. Get the best one you can get, because when you buy something like this, if you take care of it and you follow the maintenance instructions, this will last you for a very, very long time, right? I mean, these things will last for years, right? They're great. And again, it's not like you're going to be looking back and saying, oh yeah, you know, I should have bought a better one. Then there's nothing you can really do about it because you've already spent money on a generator that you don't really feel satisfies your needs. So get the best one you can afford. A big challenge is going to be to decide whether you want to get one of the bigger, bulkier DuroMax generators, which I feel are, you know, less expensive for the power, right? I feel like you get more bang for your buck on some of the less portable models. They're a little bit louder too. This one's a lot quieter than some of the other models. So, and it's very, very portable, right? You've got the wheels. Let me show you again. That's just so cool. Watch this. Boom, boom. Look at that. I love it. I'm gonna put it back in. Yeah, great. And then you can also pick it up. Oh yeah, and I'm not even right-handed, I can do it. So the portability is, timing is a really big thing when it comes to generators. And the reason I say that is whenever disaster strikes, that's when people need generators, and that's when they become more difficult to find. If you have a hurricane or a power outage due to a snowstorm or a rainstorm or a windstorm or some other reason, chances are other people will also be looking for generators. And so physical stores tend to sell out. They become harder to find online. Shipping takes longer because there's back orders. So it's always better to get it as soon as possible. Now, if you're watching this video and you're thinking, well, I don't have electricity, that's too late. I'm sorry, but it's still okay, right? Even if you buy one now, and it comes late and you get your power back, you'll have it and you can use it next time disaster. The big advantage of this particular model, well, the big advantages are,
It's dual fuel, right? So you do pay more for that because it's dual fuel, and the portability. So again, you can get a generator that is stronger than this, okay, for the same price, right, without all of these options. So it's really personal choice. I love the portability. Let me just emphasize that. Let me just say it again. I love the portability. I have looked at other generators that are bigger than this, both from DuroMax and from Champion and from DeWalt and also from Generac, and the size of this compared to the bigger bulky ones is key. This reminds me of a Honda generator. Honda makes great generators too. I mean, just really, really nice.
Well, I think if you're looking for a good generator, this is definitely one to consider. DuroMax makes great generators. Again, my advice is get the best one you can afford. And when you get it, just make sure you read the instructions and do everything correctly. And have fun with your awesome new generator. Good luck.